מוריי ורבותיי, שבוע טוב, חנוכה שמח, בשורות טובות שיהיה, הרבה הצלחה לכולם, חג מלא ברכה בעזרת השם. We have the parashat Vayeshev. It's very rare that parashat Vayeshev and Chanukah goes together, usually parashat Miketz. But in parashat Vayeshev there is a lot of important subject that belong to Chanukah too. And I would like to start with the saying it says over here, Ele todlot Yaakov Yosef ben 17 shana. And it says that Yisrael ahav et Yosef mikol banav ki ben zekunim lo ve'asa lo ketonet pasim. What does it mean? And Yaakov Avinu loved from all his brother, his children, he loved. Who did he love? Yosef. Ki ben zekunim hu lo. Those of you who know Hebrew, מה זה נקרא בן זקונים?
The child of זקנים,
נכון? רשי סיון במקום שנולד לו לעת זקנתו. מיני? דברי פירי. כל המפרשים are asking, we don't understand, all the Issachar, Zbulun, all of them were born in the same age, and he's not the youngest one. Who is the youngest son?
בנימין.
למה נקרא בן זקונים?
זה קנה חוכמה.
What?
זה קנה חוכמה.
Oh, אז אומר רשי, נארון רמי ברוך הדס, ארון דגוס תיודן, כתוב על השם התרגום אונקלוס, הרי בר חכים היה. He was very smart. Good, ברוך השם. So he's very smart. And whatever he learned, he taught יוסף. And I saw בעל התרגום, מה זה זקונים? זין זה זרעים, קוף זה קודשים, ונון זה נשים נזיקים, מם זה מועד, וניוד, מקום טעות קורא לזה ישועות, but the same thing. All the שישה סדרי משנה, he was teaching. Good. Third explanation, אומר רשי, that from all the brothers, he was the most who looked like יעקב. זה נקרא בעברית זיו וקונים, in English we call it icons, which is a sign, this is the זיו וקונים in it's a Latin Hebrew word, that says זה קונים, זיו וקונים, he was, look like him, he say בוחרת, פדר מונה, אברהם, יצחק, יעקב ויוסף, they look the same. דחזקוני, on the Torah, he goes to a different direction. And he says that Ve'im Tomar, but Binyamin is the youngest one. How do you say Yosef is the youngest one? He says that Yaakov loved Yosef more than Binyamin. Mm-hmm. You know what the reason? He says because when Binyamin was born, he lost Rachel. So there was a certain interesting relationship between Yaakov and Binyamin. He loved him as the young one, but unfortunately, it reminded him that his appearance made his wife, Rachel, lo aleinu to pass.
We know that Abraham and Itzhak look alike. It's said in Torah. When do we know that Itzhak and Yaakov look alike?
What?
Where does it say that Itzhak and Yaakov look alike?
Well, it looks like that, it says that in the in heaven, there is a picture of human being.
Yeah.
And they say it's Yaakov.
Yeah.
And they say it's look like Adam HaRishon. And we know that Abraham was like Adam HaRishon. Yitzchak, Yaakov, and Yosef. So it means there is a certain similarity. This I learned from here. Uh-huh. The Ramban, the Nachmanides on the Torah, he goes to a totally different direction. The Ramban says, I don't understand this explanation. Binyamin is the youngest one. So he says, there is a minhag of zkenim. It's very common in our community too. That the father decides from which child he would like get old with him. To be in his house, to be with him. Ben zekunim, the father, the child that he chooses to be with him. Everybody's okay, but he feels comfortable with him. לכן בן זקונים doesn't go on Yosef, בן זקונים go on Yaakov. Meaning, בן זקונים, I decided I want to be with him. Now, so we learn over here all kind of explanation. What is the right explanation? And I would like to take with you totally to a different direction. Hopefully, I will be able to explain it because it's not easy. I apologize. And if you don't understand, tell me please, because I will have to explain it. They're touching a very, very sensitive point. Before we go there, I'll go another two explanation about מה זה נקרא בן זקונים. הכלי יקר on the Torah says the follow. כתוב והוא נער את בני זלפה, בני בלעם וזלפה, נכון? מה זה והוא נער? מה אומר המדרש? עושה מעשה נערות. מה זה עושה מעשה נערות? Having fun. But when he was next to his father, he was there like a very old man. Like somebody that is very established. אומר הכלי יקר, והוא נער את בני בלעם שהיה עושה מעשה נערות כמותם ומכל מקום. His father loved him because when he was next to his father, he used to lead himself like a zaken veragil. Next to his father, he behaved perfectly. ופרקו נאה, ואולי לא רצה לשנות מן המקום, המנהג, וידע להתנהג עם הנערים ועם הזקנים. מה זה בן זקונים אומר הכלי יקר? He knows how to be with the young people is young, and with the old is old. He knows how to adjust. לכן בן זקונים is adjustable behavior. And the last one, and I saw over here, So we spoke about the Ramban, we spoke about the Kli Yakar, and we're ready to go. I was wondering, the word Zekunim, how many times it's written in the whole Torah, who knows? Zekunim. And I saw that it's written four times in all the Torah. Zekunim, Zekunim, Zekunim. Number one, ותלד שרה בן לזקוניו. And שרה, she had a boy when Abraham was old. This is the פשט. Second one, כתוב, שרה אומרת, כי ילדתי בן לזקוניו. Talk about יצחק. Third one, in our parasha, כי בן זקונים הוא לא. And the fourth time, when יהודה is telling to Yosef about the history, אמר לו, we are 12 children, ילד זקונים קטן ואחיו מת. יוסף is dead is telling him, and בנימין הוא בן זקונים. Meaning, according to this מהלך, who are the two individuals that we call them בן זקונים?
יצחק.
יצחק, יוסף, and בנימין. נכון? Now, I want to teach you something you learn for the whole Torah. The Vilna Gaon says if there is a word that comes a few times in the Torah, the first time that it comes, this is the most important time. I'm going to teach you now the word Lizkunav, what the Or HaChaim HaKadosh says, and it's not easy, but we're going to open that again. Why it's called Zekunav, Omer Or HaChaim, it's from the word plural. Zekenim, Zekunim. It's not one Zaken, it's two Zaken. And listen what Or HaChaim says. Tam ha'odaa be'omro lizkunav, be'lo amar lezikna'to. Those who know Hebrew, you have to say that Yitzchak was born lezikna'to shel Abraham, when Abraham became old. Zekunav is a plural way to say it. למה שכתבנו שהיה חסר בשעת הלידה נפש מעולם העליון להוליד. When Yitzchak was born, he couldn't have children. עוד פעם. שהיה חסר בשעת הלידה,
מי קודם? זה יצחק?
יצחק, נפש מעולם העליון להוליד. יצחק אבינו was born and could not have children, לא עליהם. ואז, אבל, when he was born, Hashem gave him another neshama as a potential, as a tool to have in the future children. ודווקא כי מכיוון שהכתוב כי ילדה ואז ילדה בו הכנה אחרת לזקנה שני של אברהם, כי יש לך לדעת כי יותר מההחלט הוא להשיג את העולם, אדם בעולם הזה, דבר חדש, אם לא יקדים הכנת המקבל כדי לחכמת האמת, ואם לא הייתה לי יצחק אלא נפש אחת ראשונה, לא תועיל לו העקדה, ואז בזמן העקדה, הגות הנשמה, תאהב את יעקב ונשא. חידוש. אומר אור החיים, מה זה נקרא לזקוניו? She gave him a boy that he has to go in his life two stages. Until 37 years old, and after 37. חכה רגע. אז עכשיו, אנחנו רואים עכשיו, ולכן הוא אומר, וזהו הדברים שמתלד לו, שילדה לשני זמני זקנו, שתי זמני זקנותו, האחת עד לדתו והשני בעקדה. It looks very difficult. What is the... What is the connection? What is going over here? And in order to explain you what is meaning according to Or HaChaim Ben Zekunin, we're talking about a certain personality, a certain neshama that comes to the world in two phases. Number one, then is number two. Number one is not so good. Number two is very good. And there is an event in the middle, and then everything will open up. And as a small introduction to explain you, if somebody doesn't have these two inside of him, he will never be able to take it out of him. Everything has to be inside of the person, and then when time goes by, it's going to happen. I give an example, just to make it in our life, because maybe it's too abstract. A couple called me this week. They are married for 6 months, Baruch Hashem. They are very happy. He walks, she walks, they are very happy. But she is not pregnant yet. So the Bukharian people are very nice people. Before you get married, they ask you when you get married, when you get married, when you get married. Cholam chimesho, I want children, I want grandchildren. I want this, I want this. Baruch Hashem, the kids got married. 7 days, Shabbat brachot passed. So nobody pushes them. Shigal. Novosti, yes. News, 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 news. And these young couple, the wonderful people, they love each other. And the parents not pushing them. And the grandparents not pushing them. They're just asking.
Any news?
So now the mother of the chatan is very worried after 6 months. And she made an appointment in the doctor to see if everything is okay, just for the safe side. So they called me to ask Rabbi, what should we do? So I told her, the mother of the chatan, please get off the wings of these people. Let them survive. And I told her a story. It happened in our community. It's not a nice story, but it's a true story. There was a couple, they were married for 10 years. And she never, lo aleinu, could have children. And the husband is a Kohen. And they cannot divorce, because if they divorce, they cannot remarry. So after 10 years, the parent says, we don't even want children, it's too much, 10 years, 10 years, 10 years. But they never fought with each other. So they had to separate. So she rented the place, and the super told her, you're going to get the keys on Sunday. So she came Sunday to take the keys. They say, I'm sorry, come in 1 week. So she came to the bedding on Sunday, we gave her the get. She thought she's getting the keys, she moved to the apartment. She doesn't know where to go. Her husband says, stay over here. I never fought with you, you stay over here. And she stayed over there. And then they called me after 3 months that they have a problem. That now she is pregnant. So apparently, after they were divorced, no pressure anymore, she conceived from him. So he can say, Rabbi, it was the mekach ta'ut, I divorced her for nothing. I say, no, it was when there is no stress, everything is okay. If everything was, he was healthy, she was healthy, the doctor says helpless, hopeless. And we had to make a lot of things to find, maybe there is the kiddushim were not good, the kiddushim. We tried to help this couple, but what was the key for her to conceive?
Stressless.
So Baruch Hashem, in our community, we are very good in not giving stress to nobody.
Yeah.
We're just asking. So I thought of this couple, wait at least 1-2 years, don't rush. Sometimes, according to what we learn over here, it takes time to the neshamot to come to the point. It takes sometimes, because it has to be until there is the attachment. Nothing happened overnight. But in our understanding, how possible? We got married last month. It has to be. It looks like something very tactic. But the only keys that are in the hand of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is how much rain is going to be, and who is going to have children, and maybe it will be the president. It's another question. I don't put politics over here. But But Mafteach Shel Chaya is by the name of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So I told you to do this couple, 6 months is a wonderful time. Extend your honeymoon, tell to your parents everything is okay. Wait, talk to me after 2 years. Let's see if they'll survive the pressure. So Omer HaOr HaChaim, he says that there are over here two, Yitzchak Avinu had two lives, until the Akedah and after the Akedah. Yosef HaTzadik, it looks to us, there is a Sefer Tzaddik between 1 to 30 years old, and from 30 years old to 110 years old. What happened from 1 until 30? He was persecuted. Everybody were enemies. His own brothers, his own family, he went to Egypt, his boss, the wife of the boss. He was in the prison, everything that happened to him, but he's dreaming. And then on Rosh Hashanah, when Paro is seeing the dreams of the cows and this, on this day, the mazal of Yosef HaTzadik changed 100 degrees. And he was until 5 o'clock, he was still in prison. 10 o'clock, he was already number 2. And running the world, he was the oldest, he was the longest reign king in the history of mankind, 80 years. That he was a king and controlled the entire world. But the first 30 years, it was for one problem to other problem. But then it comes the blossoming. I was wondering about Binyamin. What is the story of Binyamin? I tried to say, maybe Yehuda is telling to Yosef, you're the Ben Zekuni, but Achimet, he tried to tease him. But let's go on the pshat, what it says over here, and I want to tell you something that happened after we come to Eretz Israel. It's not a nice history, but it happened, and it's said in Sefer Shoftim. It's called Pilegesh Bagiva. You know the story?
Yeah, very ugly story.
So let me tell you the story in a short thing to understand. There was Pilegesh Bagiva was one of the saddest events in Israel, after we came to the land of Israel, and the tribes were divided, to each one to their own place. And there was a place by the name Givat Binyamin, who is the people of Binyamin. And unfortunately, not all of them were very spiritual. They were very strong people, extremely, extremely good soldiers, and they want to enjoy the world. So, Geva Binyamin. What happened, there was a person from Shevet Levi, and he had a wife, And she was a pileget, she was a wife without kiddushah, but she was his wife. And they had an argument. The Gemara said, what was the argument? One rabbi said she didn't prepare him the food that he liked. And he found a bug inside the food. One rabbi said that she wasn't preparing herself to be nice to him when they were living together. And one rabbi said that she left the house, she went to her father, and she was four months by her father. And then he went and said, I want to forgive me, I want to come back. He spoke to her father, and he's taking back from the house of his father, her father, back to his house. And it came one evening, there was night, there was no person outside, it was close to this small city, Geber Binyamin. There was an old man found him, he said, I see Jewish people, come to my house, stay in my house. Suddenly, few people from this small city, they got drunk, and they heard there is somebody come as a guest, and they come to knock on the door, and they say, we want to abuse them. So we told them, why do you want to abuse them? Remind you something of Sodom and Lot? Very, very similar. So he tell them, no, they are my guests. Who are you this? So they pushed him. And so he say, we're going to destroy your house. That this person say, I don't want the problems. And he went out with his pilegesh. And these young people took her and they abused her. And in the morning when she returned home from all this aggravation, she fell down and died at the entrance. And the Am Yisrael was in shock. Never in the Jewish history that young Jewish people came out of Egypt, have over here. And all the 11 tribes gathered in Israel, gathered 400,000 soldiers, and they told them, we want us, Shevet Binyamin, to give us those young people who are in charge of this crime. Shevet Binyamin told them, Adin Lafsir, Matunat Dartanin. They say, won't give you nobody. It's our people, go out from here. There were 11 tribes against Binyamin. So they went to Pinchas Ben Elazar, was the Kohen Gadol there, and they told him, what should they do? You have to go to the war, and they were fighting. In the first day, Shevet Binyamin was winning, and 22,000 soldiers died. In the second day, 18,000 people died. And on the third day, they were fighting with them, and 25,100 people of Shevet Binyamin killed. There were left just maybe 400 to 600 people, that's all, males. And they ran away. And on this day, Am Yisrael made a decision, because they didn't want to repent, they didn't want to give us the people, nobody should marry these people. Shevet Binyamin should disappear from the history. Then, Shevet Binyamin, the old people came and they spoke to other people and they did tshuva, and they say, no, we are one people, and they decided they want to make it together, but they promised already that they don't get married with them. So they say, you know what, we say we will not offer you, but if you're going to grab them, we won't tell you no. So every Tu B'Av, they used to come and used to find a girl, talk to her, then go to the rabbi, get married, and then they revealed it on Shevet Binyamin. One of them was, the first one, was King Shaul. He says on Tu B'Av, he found a girl, they came to the rabbi, so he said, okay, because already they did tshuva, they nullified the nether, and Am Yisrael, the 12 tribes, we're free. That's for one of the reasons we are very happy in Tu B'Av, that Shevet Binyamin returned to Am Yisrael. The next level, Shaul became the king of Am Yisrael, Shevet Binyamin. So you see it go to a certain, all the way, lo aleinu, totally, almost. Then suddenly, boom, he becomes the king. So, according to Or HaChaim, this is the meaning of Ben Zekunim. A person with history that goes in two waves. One Zaken and two Zaken. Why is it so important that we learn about this today? We are talking, we are now Baruch Hashem, Chanukah, the lights are on Baruch Hashem, this beautiful Makom Torah, God bless Nissan and Malkah, Shelchan Tamid Abayit Or Bezrat Hashem.
Amen.
And the understanding is like this. Sometimes in life, people feel that they don't know what to do anymore. They are stuck. But they have to know that every time there is something stopped, something good starts again. And the most important thing, we should never ever lose hope. This is the whole day of Chanukah, by the way. Yes, today in the synagogue, we learned in the afternoon, 250 reasons, the Kushiyah of the Bet Yosef. What is the Kushiyah of the Bet Yosef? The famous Kushiyah that you know. How many, we found this small jar, how much was over the oil?
One day.
How much is last? Eight days. So what was the miracle?
Seven days.
Why do we create 8 days miracle? And there is 250 reasons, like Gematria Ner. So we told them, and one of the reasons that we say 7 days was the oil, but the first day was few people, Maccabim, 20, 30, 40, very small amount of people, fighting against an empire. Their spirit, this was celebrated in the first day. A spirit of people that don't give up. We have tendency, in our days, Baruch Hashem, every small thing become like a major crisis. And this is because, unfortunately, we are not behaving like skinny, we behave like very babies. You know, there is somebody, one, a small child, they gave him a cookie and the cookie was cracked. So he said, all the cookies cracked, is for the everything become old and everything, everybody is against me and all this kind of thing. It's kind of from childish behavior. Because the real behavior that there are hardships in life, it's going to go, there are good things in life too. When I was a child, my mother told me all the time that, I don't know if you remember, when there was all kind of almonds, that few of them were very bitter, and few of them were very good. Today, Baruch Hashem, from some reason, everything in America is sweet, but I remember every 20, 30, one of them became very bitter. Yeah. And she was eating with my grandfather, and he was never complained, and she said, oh, it's very bitter. So he asked him, why it's never bitter for you, all the bitter comes to me. So we told her, no, I get it too, but I understand, it's bitter and sweet in life. There is no, you don't get in life just good, good, good. There is good, there is bad, it's an ongoing process. But as a child, you say, why it's bitter? Everybody is against me, nobody loves me, Hashem, where are you? Very childish panic. And Baruch Hashem, in once we have, there was Hollywood on board, today all of us, we have Baruch Hashem, most of us, we have the drama skills, you know. Something small happened, you know, it's the end of the world, and you start with the drama and with the reaction and everything, which is so devastating when it's come to our life. The Maccabim were fighting against the whole empire. What the chances to believe, to succeed? Zero. So the miracle was that they didn't give in. They didn't give up. And they continued. And this is the first day of the miracle of Chanukah, that we say thank you to people that they were brave to fight against it. So, Omer, בפרשה שלנו, בישראל אהב את יוסף מכל בניו כי בן זקונים הוא לא. It looks that Yaakov knew that Yosef is going to a lot of hardship in his life. You know, when Yosef has been sent by his father, Makatuf po, Katu, that the brothers went to with their ship to Shechem. Vayomer Israel el Yosef. Not Vayomer Yaakov, Vayomer Israel el Yosef. They say because now, whenever you say name Israel, is already prophecies. And he's sending Yosef from the valley of Hebron, even though it's in the mountain. Why it's in the mountain? Why it's in the valley? From Machshava Amuka. Yaakov is telling to Yosef, my son, you and your brother are not in peace. You have to find peace with your brothers. Then, you are going to call me. Before, don't call me, please. This will answer the question, Yaakov, Yosef became the king, and he became, he was 9 years when he was a king, he never spoke to his father. When he called his father?
After he made peace.
After he made peace. And now he can go to ask him to go my father. And what he's telling to his father? Ketuv, he's sending to him 10 donkeys and mules full of food,
agalot.
Plus agalot. What does it mean, agalot? Basically, it was the Egyptian limousines, by the way, with the king of that. It was the big one, very very important carriages. But it was a sign between them. Before he left, Yaakov is telling to Yosef, "You see, I'm following you few yards." Then nikra mitzvah lelavot, and somebody in the future is going to be the people send somebody without being with him and follow him, and something happened to him, they have to bring agala, a calf, igla, agala. He's telling him, and when he give him a sign, and when Yosef is sending the agalot, he say to them, tell them it is because of the agla rufa. It's made that all kind of a communication between the father and the son, but Yaakov is telling him, it's not going to be easy. Because to live in peace is very difficult. Now, our society promotes the idea there is the national American anthem, there is another anthem of America, they say, whatever I did in my life was my way. Very popular song in America.
I did it my way.
My way. My way or the highway. When it's come to marriage life, it's totally devastation, because marriage life is not my way. Marriage life is our way. But if you put too many people, too many egos inside the marriage life, say, you disagree with me? You know who you're talking to? Adding our low insecurities, the complex of inferiority complexes, and all kind of things that as children we were put down. When it's come to marriage life, everything comes out. Instead of him being happy, we feel the victims. Then welcome to the real life. And you can swear that I'm the victim, she is the victim. We spoke many times about it. Nobody's victim. We are living together. Nobody is victim. But the way of thinking, if somebody doesn't go my way, it means something is wrong. And everybody is against me. Hashem against me, my wife, my husband, and it's not true. So, I told you once, there is one of the miracles in Beit HaMikdash was, when everybody was standing, there was no place to move. When they start to bow, it became big, and everybody had 2 meters by 2 meters to bow on the floor. So the Hasidim say it was not a miracle. If you're standing, there is no space to nobody. You lower the head, there's place to everybody. There was no miracle. The Koske Rebbe said the opposite. He said it was so much space, and when you're standing, and Lamoz Nikal Itzpalel, because they move all the time, Hashem is slow not to move, they go in one place, because they like to move in the tefillah, but it's another pshat. But the idea of that, when you lower your head, there is space for everybody. But when it's you know it's... Therefore, we have to accept our life is full of challenges. But doesn't make our life that we are the victims and miserable and we are right and wrong and everything. You get to get out of this. And right and wrong is so wrong to think like this. Because then you become, Baruch Hashem, then you become the judges, and judges you know, right and wrong. But you're not a judge, because you are inside the system too. My son Jonathan was in Shabbat Chatan a few weeks ago, in Shabbat Barchot. So he said, my father taught me something. He asked me, once my son asked me, when husband and wife disagree, who is the mitzvah to say I'm wrong, the husband or the wife?
The husband.
So I say, the smarter say first I'm wrong. Now choose if you're the smart or not smart in the family. But it's your choice. If you say I'm right, you're not the smart. The first one to say I'm sorry is the smarter. Why? Because this is the will of Hashem. And how can I prove it to you? This week we had a Malach Gabriel, so it's a very good thing. How do I prove it to you? What do we say every day in the prayer when we pray in Mechaven? Baruch Ata Hashem, Melech Ohev, Tzedakah, and Mishpat. מה זה צדקה? צדקה, מה זה צדקה? Charity. מה זה משפט?
Justice.
What do you want from Hashem? Justice or charity? So what do you want? When I say I want משפט, מה זה I want משפט? Tell me I'm right or wrong. What is צדקה mean? I give you, I don't know you, but I give you because I have to give you. So what is the ברכה? Explain the פשט of the ברכה. You explain me. מה זה מלך אוהב צדקה ומשפט? What I ask from Hashem?
Right judgment.
What's the right judgment?
Letovatcha.
The idea that we ask to HaKadosh Baruch Hu want to teach us that our justice, in most of the case, is our imaginary understanding of truth, based on all kind of mental, emotional, development, the all kind of education things, somebody put something in his head, but it's not what the meaning of our Torah. Our Torah is based on tzedakah, then mishpat. I disagree with you, but it's okay, this you want, I'm doing it. And we said many times, the Chafetz Chaim story, when Chafetz Chaim was old and he made a second wife, she decided she wants the sukkah in a different location. So he built it, he was 80 in his 80s. He put from here, she put over there, he put over there, no, it was wrong, she put over here. He said, okay, whatever you say. I imagine it was another community, what she's going to hear, this poor lady, about she wants to change here and there, I was right, I was wrong. Why? Because we are missing this understanding of Torah. Omer Yaakov li Yosef, Yaakov, I'm sending you to a mission. When most of you, I was in your wedding, Baruch Hashem, you are in a mission now, husband and wife. You have to find a way to live together. Not who is right, who is wrong, who is good, who is bad. Tzedakah u'mishpat. Tzedakah u'mishpat. Okay, you want this way, it's okay. How the Yetzer work on you? But you are the victim. Husband and wife. You are not the victim. You are a human being. But you are together. And this is the most important thing. We start today about the Ben Zekunim. What does Ben Zekunim mean? And we ended what the Orach Chaim says about Itzhak Avinu Alav HaShalom. And he says that the Akedah that happened helped Yitzchak to become a father. Which the understanding is like this, sometimes there are hardships in your life. And you say why? And in this hardship, there is your salvation. In this hardship, there is what Hashem wants from us to do. So, everything we should accept the Ahava, and let things go and stop, judge everybody, ourselves, God, everybody around us. We have to get out of this kind of thing. We have to know what to do a mission. We are soldiers, Hashem told us. And we spoke last week, when Yitzchak is sending Yaakov, what he's telling him? You go to get married, you have to have 12 boys, then come to see me. He's going for 36 years, 37 years. Oh, Boruch, and now Binyamin is born, I'm coming to, this is the mission. Today we made the accounting, you know, where how old Yosef was when he was sold?
17.
And how old was Yaakov when Yosef was born? 91, true. 91 plus 17? 108. And how old was Yitzchak? He was 6 years different, 168. So when Yosef was sold, Itzhak was still alive. For how long?
For
12 years. For 12 years. And in the year that Yosef becoming the king, Itzhak died before. So I don't know what's the reason. There has to be a certain connection. But for 12 years, Yaakov, he says in the parasha, he's sleeping, he's sitting on the floor and crying. Yitzchak is sitting 1 meter out and doesn't say nothing to him. He's a prophet, I'm a prophet, nobody tells him, I can't tell him nothing. When you live your life on a mission, it's something else. So, what is our mission? As Jewish people, to keep Torah mitzvot. As a husband, to be nice to our wife. As wife, to be nice to your husband. So we are not doing a favor to each other. We are doing what Hashem asks us to do. And in order to be nice to each other, it has to be very genuine. We have to take the victimship out of the system. You are not a victim. You are imagined. You are the victim. And I can prove you 100 cases that came to me recently. Everybody swears that he is the victim. In every good victim, there is a very good aggressor, good one. So, there are a few who like to fake. They are very quiet, but they're going very deep. There was a couple came to me last week. The husband is very, very harsh with his wife, but in a very nice way. He doesn't scream. So, he said, then when she screams, he said, another time, I told him, what you're doing to her? He said, no, nothing, I just tell her what I think. No. You are hurting her. And this is our mitzvah. You got married under the chuppah, you promised. Therefore, I'll end with something that I told all of you on your wedding, on Chosheb, almost, in the Sheva Brachot at least. I think it applies over here.
Nels?
No.
Okay.
Once I had we had a very good member in our community. God bless his memory. We miss him a lot. Aaron Mirov used to come to our Daf Hayomi, a Gabbai, a nice man, very, very special person. All of us, we love him and miss him. Sheva Shamayim, Militz Yosser Elenu. And when I came to America and I wanted to buy a car, he took me to New Jersey to buy a car. So we went with him, 3 hours, first time in life, I go to auction. You see over there lane, all kind of cars, all kind of number, all kind of colors, all kind of things. And they're coming one after the one, and they're making 1,000, 1,000. I never saw it in my life. And so as a curiosity, I'm going to all the lanes. And they're very busy, but I saw over there line 22, 5 people there. So I say, why people are not going over there? And cars are coming out. I go over there, and it's not over there as is. No returns, no way to regret, whatever you take, you have.
No refunds.
As Amarti Le'Aaron, this is marriage life. You cannot return, it's what you have, as is. You take it, and you live with it. So, then I explained to me that people don't want to go because I might give them the wrong car, even though it looks nice, but and you cannot return it. But the concept of marriage life, as is, I think is very important. But what are we doing? We try to educate our spouses. We try to make them more religious, less religious, more this, I want this. Don't be a teacher. Don't be a babysitter. Don't be the mashgiach, and don't be the... just be the spouse. The husband role in the house is make his wife happy. And the wife role in the house make her husband happy. How does he want it? How does she want it? It's based on both of them. Every person is own thing. But if she want this way, this way. You want this way, this way. This is what we're talking about. We spoke about the Pelegish Bagiva. The reason that she left her husband, they said that she wasn't so clean. He found a bug inside the zay. He said, I cannot eat in your house. You are not neat. And it's one of the reasons. So what's the big deal? It's not, take whatever. No. the woman is obligated to make her husband happy, and the husband is obligated to make his wife happy. And to make happy environment in the house is a mitzvah. It's not a luxury. Once, in the old times, the husband would come home, would bring one bag of rice and sugar and this. The wife said, Baruch Hashem, now we can... Today, doesn't happen anymore. Today, we have to talk, you have to communicate, you have to explain, you have to... And Baruch Hashem, today the women are much more advanced and they want to be, and they can help sometimes. Sometimes they help them actually in the house too, to support the family. So it's more like a joint venture. So there are no victims over here. We are living together, and I have to be nice. It's a mitzvah too. Aishak Sherab Anashim is those who make your husband happy. What does it mean? Every person, what he needs. Yes. And the man who make his wife happy, it's good. Now, it doesn't mean they will not complain, because we like to complain. It's part of our the way we talk. But you see that they are happy, Baruch Hashem. יהי רצון שנזכה כולנו לחנוכה שמח. בשורות טובות, ישועות ונחמות. Those who want to get married, should here get married.
Amen.
Those who are married, should stay married.
Amen.
And those who are married, they have children, and those who have children, to have boys and girls, and enough money to pay for the tuition and the expenses, without a shame. Baruch Adonai Leolam. Amen.